Video sharing platform TikTok denies reports of a massive data breach. More from Jeffrey Hernais.
Many users of the popular social media app TikTok expressed alarm over the reported security breach involving user data. In a Twitter post Tuesday, independent cybersecurity team Beehive reported the potential data leak on the Chinese-owned social media app. Cybersecurity group Against the West, with Twitter handle Aggressive Curl, says they were able to download 790 gigabytes of data from more than 2 billion user entries. Beehive later confirmed the leak after verifying the data made accessible to the public by Against the West.
Pagkatapos na ilang oras, kinonfirm nila nga na meron ngang data leak ang TikTok. So ang sigurado sila meron data leak, pero hindi na sinasabing merong data breach o napasok ang TikTok. Kasi pwedeng mangyari to na itong mga information na to galing sa mga partner na mga kumpanya nila.
But Samaniego says, some of the leaked information were already accessible to the public. Against the West Twitter account was also later on suspended.
Nag-leak sila ng mga kukonte o ng mga ilang information. Nung tinignan ko, mga publicly available naman yung mga laman.
In a statement sent to ABS-CBN News, the social media giant says they prioritize the privacy and security of their users' data and no evidence of a security breach was found. But even if there was no security breach, Samaniego advises social media users to regularly change their passwords and activate two-factor authentication or two-step verification.
Ang two-factor authentication, sinisigurado niya na tayo talaga yun. At kailangan nating mag-input pa ng isang data. Pwedeng galing sa telepono mo, o pwedeng galing sa app, o pwedeng galing sa SMS message.
Jeffrey Hernais, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government targets to pilot test the implementation of relaxed face mask rules by the end of the year. The country's COVID task force is finalizing details of the pilot test. For now, it recommends to make mask wearing voluntary, but only in outdoor settings. The optional mask wearing will only be for low-risk individuals in low-risk settings. The task force clarifies these are just recommendations for now and not a policy.
Ayon dun sa IATF, ang kanilang rekomendasyon ay sa pag-liberalize ng ating mask mandate, and make mask wearing outdoors voluntary across the country. Ulitin po natin, outdoors po ito. Ito ay nagiging optional in open spaces or non-crowded outdoor areas with good ventilation, provided that senior citizens and those immunocompromised individuals are highly encouraged to wear their mask. Ang lifting, tuluyan na lifting ng mandatory mask mandate ay ipapilot towards the last quarter of 2022, provided na may improvement dun sa COVID-19 booster vaccination coverage. Ibig sabihin, kung marami, nag-start ang ating pagbibilang ng coverage ng boosters was a few months ago, i-confirm natin dito kay Yusek Bergere, was just a little over 50%. So kailangan i-improve natin yung statistics natin ng mga nagpa-booster na para by the end of the year, magpa-pilot test na po ng ating lifting of mandatory mask mandate.